Hi friends, Miss Odell here. I would like to introduce you to my friend Squeak. The Monster in the Bubble, A Worry-Woo Tale by Andy Green.
Sweet little Squeak never tried to step away from the warm, cozy bubble where he always did stay.
Safe from the world and things strange or new, he'd make up grand stories of what he would do. If he got up the courage to go out and see the places around him and all he could be. He'd tell of the creatures and the friends he would meet, and the mountains he'd scale to their dusty white peaks,
of the soaring through the clouds in the hot air balloon, ending in a rocket that would fly to the moon.
He imagined himself so brave and so bold that great tales about him would someday be told. But at the end of each story, Squeak would look down and sigh, "Someday I'll go, someday I'll try." 'Cause leaving the bubble just scared Squeak to tears. He'd say to himself, "Well, it's better in here." The bubble listened closely and started to see it needed to help little Squeak become free. At bedtime one night, Squeak turned out the lights, and the bubble floated softly out of sight. Yet it didn't go far, just quietly peeked in through the window where it watched over Squeak. Early next morning, Squeak woke up at dawn. He looked all around, but the bubble was gone. Then suddenly he saw at the foot of his bed a note from his bubble, and here's what it said. "Dear little Squeak, it's time that you grow. In order to do this, you have to let go of what's holding you back from starting each day. So think of me fondly as you go on your way. But if you should happen to need me again, I'll always be there. Your bubble, your friend. Hugs and kisses, the bubble."
"Bubble, my bubble," Squeak said with a cry. "What will I do without you by my side?"
And a voice gently whispered, tickling his ears, "Be strong, little one. I'll always be near." Squeak wanted so badly for his life to remain inside the bubble where things never changed. But the bubble was right. Squeak knew in his heart it was time to have fun. It was time that he start. So he took a deep breath and went on his way. He laughed and he learned. And he worked and he played, growing happier each day with all that he had done, thankful for the push from his special someone. For if in his bubble Squeak had always stayed, he wouldn't be the Squeak that he is today. The end. I hope you enjoyed the story about Squeak and how he stepped out of his bubble.